Here I'm asked to graph this quadratic equation. We know we're going to get a parabola opening down because the leading coefficient is negative. So let's first find that y-intercept. To get the y-intercept, we set x equal to 0. And you can see here when x is 0, the corresponding y-value is going to be 10. So 0 comma 10 is the y-intercept. Secondly, let's try to find those x-intercepts. To find the x-intercepts, you set y equal to 0. So in this case, you get a quadratic equation, 0 equals negative 2x squared plus 8x plus 10. So let's solve this. First thing I notice is that there is a GCF. Let's factor out that negative 2 and see what's left. What's left then would be x squared minus 4x minus 5. You should always do the mental check and multiply that negative 2 back in. To see that, you get back to where you came from. And it works. So then, factor what's left. If it doesn't factor, no big deal, use the quadratic formula. So here I'm going to factor 5 as 1 times 5. 1 and 5 adds up to negative 4 if the 5 is negative, and the 1 is plus. It's positive there. Positive 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. So then set each variable factor equal to 0. So either x plus 1 equals 0 or x minus 5 equals 0. That's the 0 property. X equals negative 1 or x equals 5. So here's my two x-intercepts as ordered pairs, negative 1 comma 0, 5 comma 0. The next step is to determine the vertex. And we have a handy formula for that. X equals negative b over 2a. That's a formula for the x value of the vertex. Okay, so here a is negative 2 and b is 8. So negative b divided by 2 times a, 2 times negative 2. All right, so negative 8 over negative 4 is 2. Now that's just the x value of the vertex, 2 comma. Now to find the corresponding y value, you have to substitute back into the original. So we're going to plug in 2 and see what we get. Okay, in this case, 2 squared is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, and we have negative 2 there. So negative 8 plus 16 plus the 10, well, that's going to be equal to 18. So the vertex here is 18. We have our vertex. We have our x-intercepts. We have our y-intercept. And we know the parabola opens down. So now we're ready to graph this. So let's draw in a blank Cartesian coordinate system and choose an appropriate scale. Okay, now let's plot our points. 0 comma 10 was our y-intercept. Negative 1 comma 0 was our x-intercept. And we had another x-intercept over here, 5 comma 0. And then 218 was my vertex. So you could see the rough sketch here is going to look like this, parabola opening downward. Let me try to sketch this up. Now here, what I'm going to do to find this point of symmetry right here to get my fifth point on the parabola is look at the line of symmetry here, the vertical line that goes through the vertex, x equals 2. And for the x value of this point, I know I have to go over 2 units to get to the center, and then 2 more units will get me to an x value of 4. And certainly the y value is going to be the same as the y-intercept here, 10. So 4 comma 10 is my fifth point. I have my two x-intercepts, my y-intercept, my vertex, and another point on the graph. Here's a rough sketch of the original quadratic.